Thank you for the introduction. Let me start by introducing my collaborators, my colleagues, my students, Alp and Olcan, my students, Cihan, Oya, Cem are my former students, Murat Saraçlar, who is a professor of speech technologies, she's an expert on, is a collaborator, and there is a large group of sign language linguists in my university, and we collaborate in this topic. First, let me start by formally defining gestures. What's a gesture? The dictionary defines gesture as a movement of the hand and the limbs to express an idea or to emphasize an idea. In HCI, of course, we were interested in using gestures to control computers. Many taxonomies of hand gestures exist. Let me explain a little bit on this chart. Hand, arms, and movements, hand and arm movements can be either intentional or unintentional. We're interested in the intentional movements. For speaking people, these movements often accompany speech, like I do now with my hands. One type of gesture is manipulative gesture. For example, when I try to open a jar, I do like this. Let's leave these aside. We're interested in communicative gestures. These can be symbols. For example, when I say she talks, this meaning she talks a lot. I may speak and do a corresponding gesture to emphasize or to give it a different meaning. Or I can say, a fish this big. So these are symbols. Or I can use acts, for example, like shooting. Or I can point to some person or some place and then refer to it. So, therefore, a gesture consists of a posture, a given shape of the hand, a hand-arm movement, and spatial information where I perform the gesture with respect to the 3D space around me or with respect to body parts. So if I do like this, this means something. If I do like this, this means something else. So